A thin walled cylinder, cylindrical metal vessel of linear expansion 10 to minus 3 per degree Celsius contains benzene of coefficient of expansion 10 to minus 3 degree Celsius. If the vessel and its contents are now heated by 10 degree Celsius, the pressure at the due to the liquid at the bottom will be equal to. If I consider a vessel of, let us say, volume over here is equal to V1 naught, and over here let me consider the, it contains benzene of volume V2 naught. Okay, alpha for vessel over here is given as, alpha 1 is given as 10 to minus 3 per degree Celsius. Since alpha over here is equal to gamma by 3, gamma will be equal to alpha by 3 times alpha. So gamma 1 will be equal to 3 into 10 to minus 3 per degree Celsius, and gamma 2 for the liquid or the benzene inside this vessel is given as 10 to minus 3 degree Celsius. Since gamma is more for the vessel as compared to the benzene, I can say that for the same change in temperature, the percentage change in the volume of the vessel will be far more, three times more as compared to that of the, that compared to that of benzene. Okay, now we have to find out when we heat it by 10 degree Celsius, what will be the increase, decrease, or what will happen to the pressure at the bottom. Okay, obviously over here the pressure will decrease, because if I consider, when the vessel expands, it will expand to V1 into T. Okay, and when the benzene expands, it will be V2 into T, and V2T is less than the V1T. Okay, the percentage change in the volume is less as compared to that of the initial part. So the percentage increase in the volume will be equal to, what is the total volume that has increased for this vessel? Okay, let me consider the area at the bottom be equal to A. Okay, let me consider that the area at the bottom be equal to A over here. Okay, so the area of this vessel will increase by the, in order to find out the area of the increase in the area, beta 1 will be equal to, it will be equal to 2 times alpha 1, which is equal to 2 into 10 to minus 3, okay, degree per degree Celsius. So basically beta 1 will be equal to, let the original area be equal to A1 naught, okay, and let the final area, let it be equal to A naught, because the area remains same for both of them. It will be equal to AT divided by A naught into delta T, that is 10 degree Celsius, okay, which is equal to delta, the change in area divided by original area will be equal to, for the vessel it will be equal to B1 into, it will be equal to 10, so which is equal to 2 into 10 to minus 2 per degree Celsius. This is the change in area at the bottom. Okay, let me find out the change in volume of the benzene. Okay, let me find out the change in volume of the benzene. So we can use the formula, gamma 2 over here will be equal to delta V for the second divided by V naught into delta theta or delta T. So basically delta V2 will be equal to, delta T is 10, so it will be equal to 10 to minus 2 per degree Celsius. Okay, the change in the percentage change in the volume over here, the percentage change in the volume over here will be equal to this part. Okay, so now the percentage, now the original volume over here, original volume over here was equal to 10 to minus 2. Okay, the original volume over here, let it be equal to V2 naught, and the final volume, let it be equal to V2T. So the change in the volume is equal to, change in volume over here is equal to 10 to minus 2. Okay, it will be equal to 10 to minus 2. This will not be per degree Celsius. This is the change in the volume over here. Okay, this is the change in the volume. So it will be equal to, this will not be, this will not have any unit. Okay, the area is changing as 2 into 10 to minus 2, and the volume is changing by 10 to minus 2. I can clearly say that delta V2 divided by delta divided by V2 naught will be equal to delta A divided by A plus over here delta H by H. Okay, it will be equal to plus delta H by H. So 10 to minus 2 will be equal to 10 to minus 2. Now the area is increasing. Okay, now the area is increasing. So basically it will be equal to 10 to minus 2. The area has increased by 2 into 10 to minus 2. The volume has increased. So over here the area has increased. So the height needs to decrease. The height will decrease by, it will be equal to minus 1 into 10 to minus 2. Okay, the height will decrease by 10 to minus 1 into 10 to minus 2. So I can say that the height is decreasing by 1%. Okay, now the benzene height has been decreased by 1%. So if the original height was H, Now the height is decreased by 1%, so it will be equal to 99% of h. Okay. Now what will be the pressure at the bottom? The pressure will simply be equal to, pressure can be simply be stated as, the pressure can simply be stated as force divided by area. Okay. Force is equal to mg divided by area. Okay. We can directly take area over here. So now since the area has increased by, now the mg over here, the m will remain same. Okay, the mass will remain same. Since the area has increased by, since the area has increased by 2%, I can say that the pressure has decreased by 2%. Okay, since the area has increased by 2%, the pressure has decreased by 2%. If you want to use the formula for the height, we have to use rho gh, but we have to find out the density also. Okay, so we will not consider this part, we will only consider the pressure, okay, which is simple to find. So the pressure has decreased by 2% when the area increases by 2%, which is equal to option number C.